Hey guys, it's your girl Belinda, and for this late evening, I'm doing a simple dish that I wanted to share with you guys. Just when you're in your kitchen and you don't really have time or you just want to do something really quick, very simple, in the pantry. I'm sure all of us have this kind of stuff in our pantry. So I just wanted to show you very quickly. I have a little bit of boiling water here that I'm going to be doing for a simple Spanish rice in the box, which you know I like to cook with this days that I'm busy. So it's a Spanish rice. It's pasta, tomatoes, and bell peppers. Spanish rice, arroz con tomate, Goya. Very perfecto for days like this. So I already have my packet open here, and that's boiling in there. I'm also going to be doing I'm going to crank this up. I'm going to be doing a little bit of these pork pieces. I'm going to be frying them so beautifully up in the fryer. So take a look at that. So I'm doing that on the side, mixed up with the rice. And then, however, days like you just, I love this stuff here. This is the deluxe cheddar white cheese. Love it. Okay, here are the packets. And I know a lot of people put these in the microwave. However, I don't put these in the microwave. I actually stick them right into my boiling water back here. It, trust me, if you try this, it cooks a lot better than sticking it in the microwave. So there's about 4 cups of these here. I already have that cheddar cheese in there. So again, like I said, something really simple on nights that, you know, you have a busy day, busy night. So I also wanted to show you the avocado. It's perfect. Like I said, as long as you can do a fingerprint in there, touch that, and you see that death, you know you got yourself a good avocado. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn this down, and after I do my plating here and all that, I will most definitely show you guys the aftermath, okay? So please don't miss it. However, I did wanna share with you very quickly, because these videos are going to be very quick, just something I just throw out there for the night. I am going to start doing my pasteles. I'm going to start doing them Monday morning. Okay, so after this weekend, Monday morning, I'm going to start with the yuca pasteles, which is the yuca ones. Getting some love up there. The yuca pasteles, which are I'm doing them with pollo, so I'm doing them with chicken, and I'm doing it my way, the delicious way, the way I season up, I adobo marinate my beautiful chicken into luscious delicious fall off the bone pieces to go into that yuca pastel. And if those of you that don't know, I am doing just the yuca as the dough for it's not going to be like, usually when people do pasteles, they mix a lot of like taro, green bananas, everything together, which is great. Tastes great. That's actually the traditional way. But, you know, also you can do it your own. You can do it separately. So that's what this girl's doing. I'm doing my yuca separately with the pollo. I'm doing my pumpkin separately with pork, just pumpkin, a little bit of green banana I'm putting in that. And then I'm also doing, the green banana as well, mixed with taro or yutia. I'm not sure yet. Okay, so it's gonna come out beautifully. However, people do mix it all up together, but I'm gonna do something different. I'm gonna do it my way, because this is my way. So a lot of people out there have done this as well too. However, I just think it's a good way. I was taught by a dear older lady friend of mine that actually taught me how to do it that way, and as well as my mother. She used to do it the regular way as well. So I'm gonna do a twist with all the things I was taught in life. So please don't miss it. So starting Monday morning, I'm gonna be just starting out doing the yuca pasteles with the pollo. So I'm just giving you a heads up. So I'm gonna get back to this and do the plating, get to bed soon, take care of my children, and just share this little simple dish that you can get take care of on a day, busy day like this. All right, so I'll get back to you in a bit.